Hello dear students, today we are going to study the address, that is your chapter number 2 from your book Snapshot. And this chapter, the address, is written by Margot Minko, and the story narrates basically that how a daughter goes to her native place, which is there in Holland. And why she moves there, why she moves back to Holland, is because she is in a search of her mother's belonging after the war. In the beginning of the story, it is narrated how the protagonist was given a cold reception. Who is this protagonist? Protagonist, first of all, refers to your main character of the story. And this refers to this young girl who moves back to Holland in search of her mother's belonging. But unfortunately, she receives a cold reception when she went to her own native place. And after the war, she went in search of her mother's belongings. After ringing the bell of house number 46 in Marconi Street, a woman opened the door. On being introduced, once when she introduced herself that who she is, the woman kept standing at her in silence. She kept standing on the door, she kept staring as if who has come back. She was not welcoming the coming of the protagonist. There was no sign of recognition on her face. The woman was wearing her mother's green knitted cardigan, which she was surprised at. Why is she wearing my mother's cardigan? The narrator could understand that she had made no mistake. She asked the woman whether she knew her mother. The woman could not deny this. The narrator wanted to talk to her for some time and then left the place. In the subsequent sections, the memories of the narrator's bygone days come to light. Her mother had provided the address years ago. During the war, she went to home for a few days. She could find that various things were missing. At that time, her mother told her about Mrs. Dolling. She happened to be an old acquaintance of the narrator's mother. Lately, she had renewed contact with her and had been coming there regularly. Every time she left their house, she took something home with her. She told that she wanted to save all the narrator. She wanted to save all their nice possessions. But all in vain. Anyhow, we identify that next door, the narrator saw Mrs. Dolling going out of their house with a heavy suitcase. She had a fleeting glimpse of Mrs. Dolling's face. She asked her mother whether the woman lived far away. At that time, the narrator's mother told about the address number 46 Marconi Street. After many days, and once when the war was over, the narrator was curious to take record of the possessions that must still be there at number 46 Marconi Street. With this intention, she went to the given address. She concluded that now it is time for me to get my things back. Anyhow, let's move on further, and we'll identify that the concluding part of the story describes the second visit of the narrator. As the narrator's first visit yielded no result, so she planned to go once again. Interestingly, a girl of 15 years opened the door. Her mother was not at home. The narrator expressed her wish to wait for her. The girl accompanied her to the passage. The narrator saw an old-fashioned iron candle holder hanging next to the mirror. The girl made her sit in the living room and went inside. The narrator was horrified to find herself in a room she knew and did not know. She found herself in the midst of familiar things, which she longed to see again, but which troubled her in the strange atmosphere. She had no courage to look around, but she no longer had desire to possess them. She got up, walked to the door, and left the room. And she finally resolved to forget the address, number 46 Marconi Street, and she moved on. So, dear students, this is basically the summary of the chapter, which will let you know many things and specifically the kind of relationship that the daughter shared with mother, and now mother is no more alive. And she went back to collect all the belongings which her mother had once upon a time given to a lady. But that lady was not willing to part away with the things which once upon a time was given to her by the narrator's mother. So, dear students, I hope this story is clear to you. I'm also sending along with it PDF notes so that you understand it better. But still, if you have any doubts, kindly ask it. And let's move on further. I wish you all the best.